Hello everybody and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the UMass Dynasty in NCAA 13. We have a committed player for UMass here. Dennis has signed. We saw that last time. He signed right on the spot, but that's just the official announcement, I guess, that he's there with us now. And we have a game to play at home against Texas State. Now, this was the second game that appeared in the live stream, so if you saw the live stream, don't tell everybody the outcome quite yet. Okay, Jim Mitchell, 1 yard shy of 600 on the year. That's going to average out just under 6 yards a carry. I think it said 5.7. And when he is not injured, he is a lethal threat out there with his 94 overall speed. So the UMass Minutemen in the tunnel, they can see their own breath. It's cold. It's a blustery night here, although you see some people in shorts in the stands. Huh? What? Oh, okay. We got some hardy fans in there, I guess. But they might be cold come fourth quarter. So here we go with the offense, handing off to Jim Mitchell, and wow, he's going to be hit hard by a couple defenders from Texas State. Wes Collins going to throw quickly to Ronnie Houston, who makes the catch. It'll be third and four after that short yardage play. And over the middle to Fosell, who makes the catch right there. First down. There we go. Short passing game coming through right there and utilizing his tight end target to get him a first down. So what is next in the offense? Well, we always want to stay balanced. So we want to get just as much run game as pass game. And Jim Mitchell right there is going to get us 3 yards. Third and seven now, though. We got to go to the shotgun. Game freezes just momentarily. But that doesn't freeze Ronnie Houston going down the sideline. Makes a catch. If he leads him in bounds, who knows? Maybe he scores. But let's not get too greedy. We'll take the catch in the first down. As you see, he's bumped to the line. And whoa! He teleported downfield. That was because of the freeze there that the game did. And it makes for quite a strange looking replay. But nonetheless, Ronnie Houston makes the catch. So here we go. First and ten. Jim Mitchell to the left. Now, they're not letting him get big chunks of yardage yet, but he does get four. So second and six now. We're going to hand off on the draw. This is Jordan Broadnext, and he's got some speed inside that 10-yard line before he is pushed out of bounds. Let's see the replay here. Nice play on the draw, and he's got quite the speed himself to get to the outside, and does right there. So we got a good 1-2 punch at the halfback position. First and goal now. Collins going to roll to the right, and he throws across his body, but Ronnie Parker's right there to catch it and fall into the end zone. Touchdown, UMass. And just like that, it is 7-0. Nice pass by Wes Collins, finding Ronnie Parker there where he can make the catch and get in the end zone. So Ronnie Parker scores the first TD of the game here. 9 plays, 84 yards. Collins to Parker for the 9-yard score, and it's 7-0. So here we go. Rhodes, the quarterback for the Texas State Bobcats. He's going to run. He's not taken down easily. He'll get a first down right there, and he's quite pumped up. Look at that. So he hands off to Franks, his halfback, who's going to get 7 on his own. It's a pretty good start here for themselves. Second and three. Quarterback taking off again, and nobody really accounting for him until he's got first down yardage. Got to do something about that eventually. Rhodes going to throw this time. Finds Griffin for a first down. And my goodness, he's throwing people off of him. Look at that. We had a hard time tackling early on in this game. Another shotgun play right here. Rhodes wants to run. That time we do account for the quarterback, and we bring him down. Nice play there. You see the spy waiting, and he never gets to that level because the D-line takes care of him. Second and 15 now, play action. He hits Durrell, who makes a catch and then makes everyone miss on his way into the end zone. Shoddy tackling right there, and we pay for it as the Bobcats strike the end zone themselves to make this a 7-7 ball game. Play action was effective. Look at the misses here on the defense tackling. He slides right off that and into the end zone. So that will not be put on the highlight tape to run a defensive clinic anytime soon, I can promise you that. But we've got a tie ball game now, and first quarter is almost over. Pass to Howard, the other tight end. He's going to get some yardage. Second and two, we try the end and round to Ronnie Parker, trying to get him involved in other ways. Well, he just goes backwards there for three. Third and five now. Collins going to scramble. Get down. Oh, he doesn't. He loses the ball. There's a flag on the field. Hold up. What's the call? Meanwhile, McClarty is running the other way with the ball. Big number 99 is tackled. What's the call? It's holding against UMass. They will obviously decline this. Holding on the center, Andy Moas. And as we said, that's declined, and that's Texas State ball. Junk Johnson not happy about the whole situation. He's probably more upset thinking that ball was down before a fumble. And he's probably not happy that the holding was tacked on. But either way, he's losing his mind. And he'll lose his mind even more when this goes in for a touchdown. Franks gets in on the ground. And just like that, Texas State is up 14-7, taking advantage of that turnover and having no problem scoring. So it's 14-7 now in the second quarter. Collins finds Mark and Michelle, drags the foot inbounds. Nice play. Second and inches. What do we got? Collins is going to throw successfully to Ronnie Parker. Ronnie Parker gets blasted. Robertson on the spot to pick it up, and he's going the other way. Is it another fumble? Oh, my goodness. They say he had possession and then fumbled. He made a move with the ball. Let's see if that's the case. He comes back to the ball on the curl route. He is hit. Yes, the ball is out there before he hits the turf. That's another turnover by UMass's offense, and we simply cannot have this on our own side of the field. We're killing our chances here. So 14-7, handoff to Franks, puts the head down, spins, and gets 6 yards. Second and four, very determined guy there. Rhodes, speaking of determined, watch this run. Makes one miss, two miss, three miss. He's hopping around everywhere, finally taking down first and goal. That guy is an animal. Look at that. He will not be caged. Rhodes handing off to Franks here. Same thing here. He's bouncing off of hits. Oh my goodness. He takes a big hit that finally spills him. But these guys are not going down on contact. And this is quite scary. Second and goal. Rhodes is going to pitch on the option. Franks nowhere to go. But yet he escapes and almost gets the touchdown. It'll be third and goal as they mark him just short. Wow, that was dangerous. He almost got in. Third and goal. Can we hold it? No, he is in the end zone for the touchdown. Finally, we put up a good fight on the goal line stand. But Texas State scores two turnovers, two touchdowns. All of a sudden, it's a two-touchdown lead, 21-7. Collins trying to press, one-on-one coverage, but he simply underthrows this ball. Mims picks it off, and we are in a world of hurt now. Texas State playing out of their mind right now. We've given them a lot of chances. I don't know. Maybe it's more us than them at this point. But either way, it's getting ugly fast. Still second quarter now, lots of time. Rhodes could strike again possibly here. Here's a pass to Lewis. He's lit up by Eddie St. Ville and drops the ball. Third and 10 now. That was a big hit because we got to make a defensive stand and make a statement. Rhodes is hit, throws out of bounds, and it will be fourth and 10. So what do they do here? They will have to punt. And Junk Johnson says, come on, get off the field. We got to get our offense out there and get it rolling again. Collins needs some momentum going. He finds Fosell. Look at him tightrope the sideline and get more yardage. That a boy. That's a great play right there. And Wes Collins maybe will settle down now. Let's see what he's got now. Off the back foot. Throws to Mark and Michelle. Gets 9 yards. There we go. We got some momentum going forward here now. 2 minutes left in the half. Collins to throw again. What's he got? He's got a pick. He did not see Rose in coverage right there. And he threw another pick. He was looking for Ronnie Parker. It did not work coming across. They were expecting it. Fans getting real nervous here. They should be taking out 2-5 Texas State. But instead, we're making them look like a pretty solid unit right now. We got to make that change. Defense, come up big for us. Come on, second and two now. Rhodes going to run. Nah, we're on to that game plan now. Hopefully, we can shut that down for most of the game. We've let that go way too much here. I believe it was Randy Smith who gets off his block and makes the big play there on Rhodes, stopping him from getting a first down. As you see the replay again, solid play by Randy Smith on the defensive line there. So upcoming will be a crucial 3rd and 5 play. We got to get this offense off the field and get a chance for our own to maybe not commit turnovers. This pass, oh, it is picked off. I was going to say almost picked off, but Stevenson not only knocked it down, he picked it up before he hit the turf. We had a similar interception last week where a ball was scooped right up off the turf. So here we go. Collins going deep. That's Ronnie Parker. He makes the catch, spins around, almost gets in the end zone on his own. They'll mark it down at the 1, first and goal. What an electric play here. They had coverage, and it was a little scary in that right, but Ronnie Parker is simply a beast. And if you give him a shot at it, he will make plays like this. Makes a catch there and stumbles and falls his way to the 1. First and goal now. Collins will hand off to Jim Mitchell. Darts into the end zone up the middle. It is now just a 1-score game. That's more like it. That's what we needed out of our offense. A quick strike to get a score before halftime. And we're right back in the ball game. So congratulations in the stands and for Jim Mitchell on the bench right there for scoring the touchdown. But that was all Ronnie Parker and Wes Collins getting them down there to the one. So Rhodes has a chance here. Again, trying to run, and our defense, give them credit. They're looking for that now. Randy Smith gets them again. Second sack now of the game here, of the half for him. So third and two. They are not defending this well. Franks comes out of the backfield, makes a big catch, and gets across midfield with 5 seconds left. Ooh, okay. They're going to attempt a really long field goal. That's like 57, 58 yards? Nope, it's short. And they left 1 second left on the clock. Let's try the Hail Mary. Get this tied up. Yeah, let's try it. Wes Collins, who knows? He's going to throw the ball deep. There's a flag. Could it be pass interference on the defense? Get us another play? Nope. Guess what? It's holding again. And who's it on this time? Brian Alexander. That will be declined, and that'll be the end of the half. Guess who's going to lose his mind once again? Junk Johnson. He's not happy with the call. He's like, come on, man. You're calling holding in all these inopportune times. You're killing our offense. He doesn't want to hear another word about it. So that is your halftime score, 21-14 Texas State. At least we've made it a one-score game despite our turnovers. Junk getting in the face of his players there. He is visibly not happy with what happened in the first half. He feels that they should be up 21-14, maybe two scores, but they're turning the ball over. So this one is a pass from Rhodes to Durrell that will be a first down. You got Franks spread out, but he's going to come across the formation and get a handoff, and he's going to get great yardage. Wow. Yeah, maybe should be expecting that. He is a running back after all. He gets a handoff more conventionally out of the shotgun here, but again, he gets great results. No tackling going on. This looks much more like early in the game when we couldn't make stops. Rhodes is going to take off again and slide. Okay, we're third and five. What's he got here? He's going to run again. Oh, he bounces off. I don't know how he gets out of that. It looked like he was going to be bundled up there. But instead, he bounces off. Look at, he has the protection of his own lineman, and no one ever actually touches him. He goes on into the end zone for the score. That's unfortunate. He kind of hid back there until things opened up and then took off. It's 28-14 Texas State. Collins forces a ball right here, just a bad pass. Trying to get it to Ronnie Parker, but not really reading the defense well. He's picked off. So here we go again. It's 28-14, and it could get worse. Rhodes has a wide-open receiver. That's Griffin. Oh, poor tackling. He gets him inside the 10. It's first and goal. We're very much in need of our own turnover here to stem the tide here, change things around, but that's not going to happen. Albritton comes in, and he gets a carry and no resistance into the end zone. All of a sudden, Texas State is opening it up on UMass here. The fans, oh, one big headache in this one. They just are not sure what's up with all these mistakes today by this UMass squad. So 35-14, Wes Collins back to throw. Wide open Ronnie Houston. That kind of sums up the game. He hits him for a first down, but they could have had touchdown if he throws this out in front of him and in the field of play. Instead, it doesn't. Ronnie Parker, he hits him in stride here. And he was real close to breaking it himself. So Collins going to throw again. This time going to Fosell, and it's another pick. Yep, just did not see the defense correctly again. Bad read leads to an interception. Here's going to be a sack and a fumble. And, yep, that's UMass's luck on the day. When they're not doing things incorrectly, they get no luck. They get a sack and a fumble, but they cannot pick the ball up. So third and four. Franks going straight ahead. Oh, the market short. Fourth and inches. So they punt. Third quarter almost up. Collins going to throw. That one's wide open to Dobbs. Will make the catch. First down. 12 seconds left in the third quarter. Trying to hurry up because they got a lot of scores to make up. Open but overthrown. Mark and Michelle. Whoops. Yep, he was open. Fourth and five now. They're going for it because, well, they're down a few scores. That ball's just flat dropped. That doesn't help. So turnover on downs right there. And we are coming after them there. They're trying to set up a screen. Never got it off. There's a sack. Third and 16. Rhodes. Yeah, he's got time to throw this time. What's he going to do? Oh, he finally throws to the end zone. Touchdown. Oh, he dropped it. My goodness. That was an easy touchdown right there that they just dropped. Instead, they'll go for the field goal. This one much more makeable, and they do make it. 38-14. Wow. I don't think there's any coming back from this. As a matter of fact, we mass sub the second group in. Matthew Quinn is in there throwing to Jordan Broadnax and getting a first down, getting out of bounds. What can Quinn do in mop-up? Let's see. He gets hit hard here but throws this downfield, and he gets
Bailed out by Dunn, making a great catch right there. Wow, he got up and got that one. Here's a pass to Howard. He decides to throw down on the turf because he didn't really particularly want to catch the ball, I guess. I don't know. That was kind of a strange play. Fourth and 10. Yep. Same fate as Collins most of this game. He's picked off. Hamilton gets him. And that squashes another drive. So here we go with 1:15 left, third and 13. Rhodes will be sacked again. They did get quite a few sacks in this game. They got after him, but there were quite a few plays they didn't make. So punting on fourth and 22. This game is pretty much just elementary now, but Quayshon Smith will take this to the right. Now back to the left, and he's got some room. Nobody's out in front of him. They're all chasing him. He will score. So we got a special teams return touchdown. Too bad it's much too late. We could have used that much earlier in the game. So it will make the score a little bit closer, 38-21, but it's time to close this out, and Rhodes will do just that, running on his own for a first down. After that, it's kneel down and take the victory. An impressive road win if you're Texas State and you're 2-5. If you're UMass, well, you laid an egg today, and you got to just kind of put it behind you. That's two losses in a row. And now you got to get ready for a trip to the Alamo Dome to play UTSA. Texas San Antonio coming up next. So, disappointed fans leaving the stadium here in UMass. They thought they were definitely going to rebound and get a win here today, but instead they dropped their second straight and they're now 5-3. Collins visibly upset with his performance. He got pulled late. Well, all the starters got pulled late, both offense and defense. Terrence Franks runs for 92 yards and two scores, even has some receiving yards, so he's your player of the game. UMass dejected leaving the field, but you know, you got to have a short memory in college football, because you come right back at it next week, and regardless of what happened, whether you had a big win and a high or a bad loss and a low, you got to come back and play the next game like it never happened. So here we go to the recruiting now. Eddie Galloway, who we've been after for a long time because he's one of those Maryland guys we want to start a pipeline with. Well, he's a soft commit to Maryland now. We're most likely not going to get him. I've never had any experience with overturning a soft commit. If you have, let me know about it in the comments, because I would like to know your best success story on maybe stealing one of those soft commits away. I've never had it happen personally. Looking at Justin Townsend here, some of these guys we added to the board later on who are intriguing to us now. Marcus Calhoun, same way. Kind of just checking where we stand on their boards this week and what we can do to get them here at UMass. Greg Vaughn, another one here, outside linebacker. And we will scout some of these guys up. We have scouted some of these guys up. And we'll continue to scout them to see where we can find gems, where there might be busts that we want to avoid. Daniel Jones, a halfback here, 73, but only 45% scouted. So he's another guy who will need some scouting. You got Eric Bentley, who is a quarterback, who's a 71 overall. Now keep in mind, quarterback right now, Wes Collins, I believe, is a 70 overall. But this guy isn't completely scouted. We got Steve Matthews here, a guard, who may be able to help us. So we're going back here now. Marcus Calhoun, we're going to scout him a little more. And we're only 78% done, but he's in 80, which is actually a drop of 5. But, I mean, wow, 80 would be more than impressive for us. So Greg Vaughn, also scouting out him a little more. We get him up to 70%, and he's a 77 now. Now, like I said, Bentley, we don't know. 71 overall. Is he going to drop from that? Is he going to go up from that? His trend is to drop, and he's going to drop even a little bit more. So 69 overall. All of a sudden, not quite as impressive. Steve Matthews here, 73 overall. We haven't scouted him at all. We're going to scout hard for an hour on him and see what we can find out. And he goes the opposite way. Check this out. When it's all said and done, he's a plus 5, 100% scouted. He's a gem, and we would love to have him in there to solidify the line. D-tackle Bo Nelson, would love to get him in here. He's only a 3-star, but he's an 80 JUCO player from Apple Valley, Minnesota. Yes, sir. Justin Townsend is the number one quarterback prospect out there, so you know this might not be realistic, but we are number 3 on his board. We'll hang for a little while and see what happens. Again, Marcus Calhoun, will actually talk to him now after scouting him. We're not making big numbers with these guys yet, but you know, we'll keep trying to do the best we can to land a couple of these guys to solidify our roster going into next year. That's the best you can do, is say, hey, you know, we got the winning record this year. We're better off this year than we have been at any point in the history of Junk Johnson's tenure anyway. And so Alex Dennis here, that's just a list of the four who have committed already, so you can see that to kind of remind yourself. So that'll do it for the episode. Next week, it's UTSA. Yes, that's Hurricane's team. No, he won't be controlling them. But we'll take a trip to the Alamodome next. We'll see you then.